16. In the large room of the barracks there was a great number of men, naval, artillery, and infantry officers. Some were sleeping, others were conversing, seated on the shot chests and gun carriages of the cannons of the fortifications. Others still, who formed a very numerous and noisy group behind the arch, were seated upon two felt rugs, which had been spread on the floor, and were drinking porter and playing cards. "A Kozeltzoff! Kozeltzoff! Capital! It's a good thing that he has come. He's a brave fellow. How's your wound?" rang out from various quarters. Here also it was evident that they loved him and were rejoiced at his coming. After shaking hands with his friends, Kozeltzoff joined the noisy group of officers engaged in playing cards. There were some of his acquaintances among them. A slender, handsome, dark-complexioned man, with a long, sharp nose and a huge moustache, which began on his cheeks, was dealing the cards with his thin, white, taper fingers, on one of which there was a heavy gold seal ring. He was dealing straight on and carelessly, being evidently excited by something, and merely desirous of making a show of heedlessness. On his right and beside him lay a gray-haired major, supporting himself on his elbow, and playing for half a ruble with affected coolness, and settling up immediately. On his left squatted an officer with a red perspiring face, who was laughing and jesting in a constrained way. When his cards won, he moved one hand about incessantly in his empty trousers pocket. He was playing high, and evidently no longer for ready money, which displeased the handsome, dark-complexioned man. A thin and pallid officer, with a bald head and a huge nose and mouth, was walking about the room, holding a large package of banknotes in his hand, staking ready money on the bank, and winning.